Hello everyone, how are you? Our lesson today will be about division by single digit number without regrouping in textbook page 73. So we will talk about division by single digit numbers. So we will start with the simple numbers that you have here, 9 divided by 3, that you will ask yourself, where or how many groups, how many numbers in each group? If I want to cut this 9 into 3 groups, I will have how many in each one of them? So how many in each one of them? Or groups of 3, groups of 3, how many number, how many units in each one of them? Now, in this case, you have to remember that you have a multiplication fact, which is 3 times 3 equal 9. So you remember the multiplication table, the times table. Remember that you will find it on the times table for 3. So find this number, it's 3 here, and try to look at this table. It's the times table for 3. If you multiply it with 1, if you multiply it with 2, if you multiply it with 3, and so on. So you will find number 9 on the times table of 3. And this is what makes this exercise easy, because you can find number 3 on the times table, on number 9 on the times table of 3. So the answer will be very clear, which is 3. So if you divided number 9 on 3, you will find 3 on each group. So 3 times 3 equal 9. And we will do here some exercises. You have to remember each time the times table for each number. If you want to divide it 24 on 6, you have to remember the times table for 6. What the number that you multiply it with 6 equal 24? It's 4. 4 times 6. 30 is 36 divided by 9, it's 4. 4 times 9 equal 36. It's by chance. Okay, 72 divided by 8, it's 9. So 9 times 8 equals 72. And here, 8 divided by 4, it's 2. 2 times 4 equal 8. And 45 divided by 9 equals 5. 5 times 9 equals 45. And if you look at 25 divided by 5, I can find the 25 definitely when I multiply 5 times 5. And here I have 18 divided by 6. If you look on the times table of 6, you will find the 18 on the times table. 3 times 6 equals 18. 9 divided by 1 equals 9. And 3 divided by 3 equals 1. This is easy. Now, you know, if you have the number on inside that times table, it will be very simple and it will be very easy. But what if this number, it's not a multiplication fact. It's not from the facts family. So you cannot find number 4 on inside or number 9 inside the times table for 4. Take a look at the times table over here. You have 4 times 1 equal 4, 4 times 2 equal 8, and 4 times 2, 3 equal 12. Now, you don't find number 9, but you have to choose 9 or less. Remember, I'm talking about you have to find the number or less. Yani any number close to 9, but exactly 9 or less than 9. Exactly 9 or less than 9. Now you have over here, I choose 8. I have two choices. I have 8 or 12. Is it closer to 8 or 12? It's sure closer to 8, because I will take the number or less than the number. So it's 9 or less, so I will choose 8. So I'll have a leftover. I have leftover because I choose less number, so I will have some leftover. So the answer is going to be 2. I have 2 times 4 equal 8, and I will have 1 leftover after I divided this group. So in each group of these, I will have 2, and I will have 1 as a leftover. So in case of the symbol, a symbol exercise or symbol division, you will find it on the times table. In case you don't have, you will find the number, the exact number or less, and you will have a leftover, 1 leftover or more. And after that, if you have more complicated exercises, you have to use another way, which is called the long division. Okay, the long division. Now, in the long division, you have this shape. You have to write it this way. I will draw it usually this way, and I will explain what each color means. So the first one, you have to write over here the number that you are dividing up. So it's usually will be the big number, okay? And we called it in math the dividend, okay? And it's usually the biggest one, okay? And then you will write over here the number that you are dividing by, and we call it the divisor, the number that you are dividing by. So into groups of what, so it's the divisor, and the last one, it's where the answer will be, it's the quotient, we call it the quotient. Okay, so we will write the big number over under the line, under here, over here, and I will write the divisor over here, and I will write the answer over here. We will see with the exercises what does that mean. Let's take this exercise. I have 23 divided by 5. Okay, I know that it's not easy to find the 23. It's not easy to find the 23 on the times table of 5. So I will remember the times table of 5. Okay, so how many 5s to make 23 or almost? Okay, almost. Maybe I will have some remainder. That's why I said or almost. Now remember the times table for number 5. I have 1 times 5, 5, 2 times 5, 10, 3 times 5, 15, 4 times 5, 20, 5 times 5, 25. Okay, I don't want to exceed it. I have 23. I will find the 23 or less. 23 or less. So look here. I have a less than 23, which is a 20. Okay, so on which number? It's 4 times 5. It's when I multiply 4 times 5, I have 20, which is 23 or less. So I will choose 23 over here. I will write the 23 here as a dividend, and the divisor is 5. And I have 4, which is the answer. 4 times 5 equal 20. I write 20 down here, and I subtract it after I'm done, and I write 3 as a remainder. Okay, so the answer is 4, and the remainder is 3. Now let's take another exercises. Over here I have 57 divided by 6. 57 divided by 6. So how many 6 do I have to make 57 or almost? How many times do I need to repeat it? How many times I need to repeat number 6 to make 57? Okay, again, remember the times table. Remember the times table. Look at this. I have to find 57 or less. 57 or less. I'm not allowed to take a bigger number. So I find 54 over here. I find 54, which is less than 57. And I find it on number 9 over here. When I multiply number 6, this is the 6. I have it here. I find it on number 9. So I find it on number 9. I will write 57. It's on 9, which is the answer. So I repeat it 9 times. 9 times, so I can get 57. So 9 times 6 equals 54, which is this number. And I have a remainder of 3. Okay, I will do some exercises more details so you can understand how I'm doing that. But you have to find always the number or less, the exact number or less. Now I will do 84 divided by 4. I will show you in this how can you do it. You write the dividend under the horizontal line over here, the dividend, and the divisor over here, and you will write the answer in the top. Now the first thing, I look at the first number here. Okay, look at number 8. How many 4, you ask yourself, how many 4 in number 8? I have 2 4s. Write it on the answer because you are answering now, so you have to write it on top. Now, okay, I have two answers, so let's multiply it with 4 and write the answer under the number. So 2 times 4 equals 8, write it under 8. Then you have to subtract them and write the answer, which is 0. Okay, now I'm done with the first number. Okay, I'm done with number 8. I look to the next place, which is 4. How many 4 in each 4? I have 1. Write the answer. So I write it down over here, number 4, and I start asking myself, 4 divided by 4 equal 1. Then I multiply it again down. So 1 times 4 equal 4 and subtract it to have 0. So the answer is I have 21, 4 and 0 remainders. Okay, 0 remainder because I have 0 down here. So if you multiply 21 or repeat the 21 4 times, you will have 484. Okay, let's take another exercise. I have a bigger exercise now. I have 632 divided by 3. I write it this way, the dividend and the divisor, and I will write the answer in the top. Now let's take the first one, which is 6. How many 3 in 6? I have 2 3s. So 2 times 3 equal, write it down, which is 6. take away, and the answer is 0. Okay, we will send the 3 now. Here, I will look to the next place now. Get it down. I will write it down over here. 3. How many 3 in the 3? Ask yourself again. Divide it again. 3 divided by 3 equal 1. And 1 times 3 equal 3 and subtract it. And your answer is 0. Now I have to write 2 down. Okay, get this 2 down. I will write it down. So 2. 2 divided by 3. Oops, it's not enough. So what I have to do, I have to write 0. So I have 0 threes on 2. Okay, 0 threes on 2. So 0 times 3 equals 0. And the answer is 2 is a remainder. Okay, so I have 210. And 2 left as a remainder, okay, if you multiply it this way. So this way we end our lesson. This is how our lesson is end. And please practice more on your notebook so you can understand and repeat the video many times so you understand how can we do the long division. Next time we're going to do the division by regrouping. So please practice without regrouping so you'll understand more the division with regrouping. Thank you so much.